Hello, good morning everyone. Again we'll start with the topic. My name is Hari Mohandai. Polar plot study, we discuss about polar plot under frequency response. It is a part of control system engineering. So actually yesterday we studied steps to draw the polar plot, how we'll draw the polar plot of a basic transfer function. So I will just go through what we have studied yesterday. Steps to draw the polar plot. What we have done, we have taken the transfer function of the given system like g of s, and we have put s is equal to j omega in the given transfer function. Then after we found magnitude and phase of the given transfer functions by taking the modulus mode and argument, that means angle of the g of j omega. Now the third step, what we did, we put omega tends to 0, that means omega is equal to 0, and the value of magnitude as well as phase to find out the starting point, that means where this, from where this plot will be started. And the secondary, we put omega is equal to infinity in the magnitude and phase value to determine where the plot is going to be end. And then after we draw the polar plot. So today we'll see the polar plot of the next type of system, like type 1 system. So we have taken an example, g of s is equal to 40 divided by s into s plus 1 into s plus 2. So you may take any other transfer function, but this is one of the simplest example. So I will see here. So again we'll start with the step. First step is we'll put s is equal to g omega in the given transfer function. So g of g omega will be 40 divided by j omega. I mean, why it is a type 1 system? Because it is here, it is the individual s term, the power of individual s term is 1. So now we'll put s is equal to j omega. G of j omega will become 40 divided by j omega into j omega plus 1 into j omega plus 2. That means we have replaced s with j omega, and it may be written as 40 divided by 0 plus j omega. We can replace, like j omega plus 1 can be written as 1 plus j omega and 2 plus j omega. We'll write this one as a equation 1. Then step 2, what we'll do, find out the magnitude and phase. Magnitude means the modulus of the g of j omega, as we have discussed in the previous section. Like how we are taking that modulus, that means if it is the x plus, in terms of x plus iy, then it is nothing but under root x square plus y square. Similarly here, because here 0 plus j omega, if you are taking under root 0 square plus omega square, then it will be only omega values we'll find out, and here it will becomes 1 plus omega square, and this one will be 4 plus omega, because 2 square is equal to 4 plus omega square. And the angle of g of g omega, that is we'll find out, like 1 by j omega, the angle of 1 by j omega already we have, I have shown you. The angle of 1 by j y is nothing but minus 90 degree. So here the 1 by j omega, wherever we will find out 1 by omega, you will have to put minus 90 degree. If it is this j omega part will be in numerators, then it will be plus 90 degree. So minus 90 degree, and for this part 1 plus j omega, it will be minus tan inverse omega and minus tan inverse omega by 2. Already we have studied how we'll find out this one. So it will be the equation number 3, this is equation number 2. So now the third step is to put omega tends to 0 in equation 2 as well as equation 3. So first we'll put the j omega tends to 0 in equation number 2. So limit omega tends to 0 mod of g of g omega, 40 divided by, in the place of omega we put 0, 1 plus 0, 4 plus 0, and it will be nothing but 40 divided by 0. You'll find out the magnitude is nothing but infinity. That means at omega tends to 0, our magnitude, the plot will be started from infinity. And similarly we'll put omega tends to 0 in equation number 3. It will be nothing but minus 90 degree, minus tan was 0, again minus tan was 0, and we'll have minus 90 degree. So from the equation 4 and 5 we find out that the plot will start at minus 90 degree from infinity. Step 4, we'll put omega tends to infinity in equation number 2 and equation number 3. So again omega tends to infinity, will put mod of g omega, 40 divided by, at place of omega we'll put infinity, under root 1 plus infinity, under root 4 plus infinity, and we'll get 40 divided by this total value will be nothing but equal to infinity. So 40 divided by infinity is 0. This is equation number 6. So the equation, I mean our plot, will end at a magnitude of 0. And in equation number 3, again we'll put omega tends to infinity. So angle of g of g omega is equal to minus 90 degree, minus tan inverse infinity, and again minus tan inverse infinity. So as we know that tan inverse infinity is equal to 90. Again here is also 90, so 90, 90 and 90, it will be equal to minus 270 degree. So we have taken a small table. It shows that where the plot is going to be start and where the plot is going to be. Only two points we need. In between the phase we'll have an approximation. Like first phase, the starting point will be at minus 90 degree, the magnitude will be infinity. So it will start from infinity at minus 90 degree angle, and the end it will be magnitude at 0, and the phase will be minus 270 degree. And that means at minus 270 degree axis, 0 magnitude it will be end, the graph will be. So now I'll show here the graph. So we have taken again the axis. That this is nothing but real axis, this one is imaginary axis. So always we are taking the negative axis. Like in the positive way will go 0, 90, 180 and 270, but because we are getting all the angle in negative, so that's why we have taken 0 in reverse manner. That means clockwise direction, 0 degree, minus 90 degree, this axis will be minus 90 degree, minus 180 degree, and this minus 270 degree. So let's see the from where the graph is start. Graph is start at phase minus 90 degree. So find out where is the minus 90 degree. This is the minus 90 degree axis, and where is infinity, the magnitude infinity. So this is the axis here, like it will be magnitude 1, 2, 3, 4 and go on. So infinity will be somewhere at like end part of this axis, minus 90 degree. So if you are taking any point from infinity and you are bringing it, it will be nothing but parallel to this axis. So that's what we have considered, that is starting point, that means omega is equal to 0. The graph will be start from infinity, it will be nothing but parallel to the minus 90 degree. Okay, that means graph will start at minus 90 degree axis, minus 90 degree axis from infinity. So this is the second is where it will be end, and at minus 270 degree, and the magnitude will be 0. So where is the minus 270 degree axis? So this is minus 270 degree axis. And if I'll ask you where is the minus 270 degree and magnitude 1, the magnitude 1 will be somewhere here. So if it is magnitude is 0, so at minus 270 degree, minus 270 degree magnitude will be 0. So it will always cross minus 100 degree, and it will go till minus 270 degree, but it won't cross 270 degree axis. So it will, now the point will come into your mind that where this point will cut, I mean this where it will crosses the minus 100 degree axis. So randomly we have considered any point where it is crossing this point. You may take here, 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 somewhere, but then after we'll find out exact point where this graph and the plot is going to intersect this minus 100 degree axis, and it we will discuss this point. This one we have found out already, omega is equal to, at the point omega is equal to under root 2, it will cross this minus 100 degree, and the magnitude from 0 from this point to any origin to the intersection point, the magnitude will be approximately 6.67. Okay, so we'll discuss this part in next lecture. So I hope you learn, you have understand that the graph will be, the Bode plot will be start from minus 90 degree axis from infinity, and it will be end at minus 270 degree at 0 degree magnitude. So that means nothing but omega is equal to infinity. Here omega is equal to 0 and omega is equal to infinity only represent the starting point as well as end point. That's it. Don't have to confuse it because it is here 0 and we are putting it omega is equal to infinity. Here it is infinity and we are putting omega is equal to 0. Omega is equal to 0 indicates that it is the starting point, and omega is equal to infinity indicates that it is the end point. I hope so you are clear. If you have any kind of problems or any query, please mail me at harimohanrai@gmail.com. Thanks for watching.